Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to another week of Sunday School. We are so happy you can join us. May the Lord reward you and bless you for your faithfulness. Now, are you guys ready for today's lesson? All right. Now, before we find out today's letter and word, let's talk to the Lord first. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, for everything that you have given us. Thank you for life, Lord. Thank you for the scriptures. Thank you that we can learn more about you. Help the kids be attentive and guide my words. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Most High, the Almighty God. And even though you are exalted in the Most High, you care about us, you love us, you're patient, and you hear us, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We ask you that you guide us in your ways and help us to walk humbly before you. In Jesus' name we pray and thank you. Amen. Hi, boys and girls. So here are some pictures of some skyscrapers. These are very, very tall buildings that you could find in some cities. And sometimes when you're driving up to a city or even from an airplane, just as it's coming down to land and you're closer to the land, you can see these very tall buildings from up high or from a distance. And many times the cities are very proud of their skyscrapers and their tall buildings, and people go visit these cities to see them. Sometimes cities want to be the city with the tallest tower in the world or with the tallest building in the world. Why? Well, because they want that recognition. They want that they want people to know who they are because of the tall tower or tall building. Now, do you think this is something new? Well, we're going to read about this in the Bible, actually. So this has been happening from very, very long time, from a very long time ago. Now, we're going to read in Genesis chapter 11. So Genesis is the very first book in the Bible. Genesis chapter 11. And this story is the Tower of Babel. Now, after the flood, after Noah and the times of Noah, the people multiplied and they began to spread out. And some people went to a land called Shinar. And they decided they were going to do something. And this is what it says. So in verse 3, it says, "And they said to one another, 'Come, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly.' And they had brick for stone and bitumen for mortar. Then they said, 'Come, let us build ourselves a city and a tower with its top in the heavens, and let us make a name for ourselves, lest we be dispersed over the face of the whole earth.'" So the people wanted to build this their city and a tall tower that reached up to the heavens. So a very, very tall tower. And they said, "Because let us make a name for ourselves." They want to be recognized for it. They want to be known for it. They want for other people around them to see this tall tower and recognize them. And so, "And the Lord came down to see the city and the tower, which the children of men had built. And the Lord said, 'Behold, they are one people, and they have all one language. And this is only the beginning of what they will do. And nothing that they propose to do will now be impossible for them. Come, let us go down and there confuse their language, so that they may not understand one another's speech.' So the Lord dispersed them from there over the face of all the earth, and they left off building the city. Therefore, its name was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language of all the earth. And from there, the Lord dispersed them over the face of all the earth." So boys and girls, the Lord came down to see the city and the tower. So the Lord saw what they were building. And at that time, all the people spoke one language, and they had the same, there weren't multiple languages, it was just one. So when the Lord saw what they were doing, he stopped them. How did he stop them from continuing? Well, they were working together to build this tower. And so he confused their language, so they couldn't understand each other. And by not understanding each other, they couldn't work together. And they ended up stopping from continuing to build their city. And this is called the Tower of Babel. And from there, the Lord dispersed the people, or he spread the people over all the earth. Now, boys and girls, why did God stop them? Why did God stop them from continuing? Now, how high did the people want to build this tower? they wanted to build it all the way up to the heavens. They wanted to build this tall, tall tower. Now, why? Why did they want to do this? They wanted people to see their great tower from far away, and they would become the center of attention. This was selfish ambition and vain conceit. They wanted to be above everyone else, and this tower would lead them and was leading them to excessive pride. And they were looking at themselves with very high regard, and it would lead them to feel that way as well. And they were looking to exalt themselves. They were looking to bring glory to themselves and their city and their tower. Now, the people's heart, the heart of the people was prideful. And this would only lead to further sin and to destruction, because before destruction comes pride. And so they were not seeking God. There was no room for God in their thoughts. And so were they building this tower to bring glory to God or bring glory to themselves and their city and their tower? Well, they were bringing it to them, not to God. Now, last week we learned that God is king over all the earth. He rules over all the nations. There is no higher power. There is no higher authority than God, the creator of the heavens and the earth. He is king of kings and lord of lords. And so all the honor, all the glory, all of our worship belongs to him and him alone. Only he is deserving of it. Yet the people were trying to bring glory to themselves and their city. Now, God is the most high. He is the maximum authority and power. He is the maximum rank. No one or nothing ranks higher than he. And this is our word for this week, that God is exalted. No one, nothing ranks higher than he does. And so our letter is X, although the word doesn't start with the letter X, it starts with the letter E. But we're using the word exalted for our X word. So God is exalted. Now, we're going to read some Bible verses that that emphasize this, that show us that God is exalted and how much higher is God than anyone or anything. So we're going to actually begin with your memory verse, which is in Psalm 97, chapter 97, verse 9, and it says, "For you, O Lord, are the most high over all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods." And that's gods with the lowercase g. "For you, O Lord, are most high over all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods." God, the Lord, his rank is higher. He is the maximum authority and power over all the earth, over everything. He is the most high. Hi. Now, boys and girls, let's take a look at some other verses. So in Psalm, now chapter 99, so just a couple of pages over, it says, verse 2 says, "The Lord is great in Zion. He is exalted over all the peoples." So God is exalted. He is higher than all the people, than any single person. It doesn't matter if you're the king of any country, the prime minister, if you are the top CEO of the biggest country, the biggest company, if you are the most richest person in the whole wide world, it doesn't matter. God is exalted over all the peoples. He is the most high. Now let's go to Psalm 148, so chapter 148, verse 13 says, "Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His majesty is above earth and heaven." Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. Boys and girls, even God's name alone is far greater than any person's name, than anyone's name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. And God is high above anyone or anything. He is the most high. And boys and girls, very rarely will someone with with a lot of power and with a lot of authority, or even with a lot of money, for example, very rarely will a person be kind or loving, patient. Very rarely will that person give you their time to hear you come speak to them. So for example, if it's a king or a prime minister, or how about the CEO of a large company, it's very hard to come to them, to have access to them and speak to them, because they're very busy. They're like the top, right? And someone who's not near or around them, it's going to be very hard to speak to them. And so if you want to talk to the prime minister, it's very difficult to do so, right? And so what is so amazing and so wonderful and just incredible is that God, who is the Most High, who is the maximum authority, who is the maximum power over all the earth, over everything, He, God, is love. God is kind. God is patient. God hears His people. God is all of the amazing things that we have been learning about. God opposes the prideful, but he will hear the humble. And that is an amazing thing. And for example, God will save the humble. God will give grace to the humble. God will guide the humble in righteousness and in His ways. And we need to humble ourselves. We need to recognize that God is the maximum authority and power. We need to submit to Him and be humble and not do things searching and wanting our glory for ourselves and attention for ourselves, but doing things for God and for His glory and giving Him the praise and glory in all things that we do. And so there's another verse in Isaiah chapter 57, verse 15, part A. It says, "For thus says the one who is high and lifted up, who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy, I dwell in the high and holy place, and also with him who is of a contrite and lowly spirit." So God is the Most High. He lives in the high and holy place. And it says, and also with him who is of a contrite and lowly spirit. What does that mean? He is with those who are humble. He is with those who feel so sorry for the sin and so sorry for the things that they have done. And being humble, recognize, if you are humble, you recognize that you are a sinner, that we are undeserving of anything, that we do not deserve God's grace. We do not deserve God's love and forgiveness. And we and being humble, you repent, you feel terrible for the sin in your life, and you recognize that you need a savior, you need Jesus Christ, you need God in your life. And even though God is the Most High, listen to what it says in Peter chapter 5, verse 6 and 7. First Peter chapter 5, verse 6 and 7. It says, "Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that at the proper time he may exalt you, casting all your anxieties on him, because he cares for you." God is the Most High. He is exalted. Yet, if we should humble ourselves before his mighty hand and know that he cares for you. Even though he's the maximum authority and power, he cares for you. Come to him. He says, "Come to me. Whoever comes to me, I will not cast out." Come to him and let him guide your life and be a part of your life, and let the maximum power and ruler guide your life, and he will take care of you. He will exalt you at the right time. And this is a beautiful and wonderful thing. So everything that you do, give glory and praise to God and seek his glory and not that of your own.
Hey, METKids! Another very happy Sunday to each and every one of you. I hope you're enjoying the beautiful weather outside. It's gorgeous and sunny and all the new leaves are blooming. I'm not quite sure why I'm wearing a sweater right now, but I'm sure a lot of you guys have been wearing t-shirts outside. Hands up if you guys have been wearing t-shirts all the time. I know I have. So, to praise God for this beautiful creation that we have outside, we're going to sing a few songs together this morning. So the first song we're going to be singing is My God is So Big. So everybody get up on your feet, and we're going to sing all together. Everybody. Now we're going to be singing our second song, and this one I am sure all of you guys know. Get out your little lights, everybody. We're going to be singing This Little Light of Mine, and I want you all to do the actions, sing along together. Parents, I want you guys to do this too. So let's go worship God together. Sunday. You guys did an awesome job, and enjoy that beautiful weather. Happy Sunday, METKids. Bye.